Today's video, we need to go and find Ed because we've had some questions in the YouTube comments that we would like to answer for those YouTube commenters and for you at home.
Hi Yetis! Sorry, this is all a bit temporary. We've just moved in, but I'd love to answer some of the questions that Lizzie says that we've got. Okay, cool. So let's go and get a vacuum. The idea is that the XBeam comes along and the vacuum tube runs all the way through the XBeam and then come over here and it comes out this side. Pull that out and just engages into the carriage like that. And that means that it doesn't flop around. You can see through the design. It's not getting under your feet. And it's, you know, we designed that because we use this all the time and it's gonna work, you know? And the vacuum is a really important part of that. Hope that helps. Okay, great question. And this design is very different actually from the way that a lot of traditional CNCs work. As you know, big CNC, the reason they're big is because they need a big flat bed, but that's not mobile. This design is mobile. And the way that we're able to do that is by having a Hinson mechanism in the X-beam. So I'm gonna show you that really quickly to illustrate how that works. So what we've got are rollers on the bottom of the X-beam and rollers on the top of the X-beam. And we can split the two halves of the X-beam, and then when the material is in, we clamp those rollers together and that holds the material. Okay, so while we're on the topic of material loading, this is obviously for the large format sheets of material, which what the whole design is based around, but it also does small format well as well. So I'll just show you what the approach is for that too. And now what we've got is a smaller format table, which we can either screw into, use dogs using these holes here, stick back tape works well as well. And the bench can operate quite happily in this smaller area on smaller pieces. So for thin aircraft gauge aluminium sheets, it's possible to adjust the rollers such that the screws will miss the rollers, or you could stick down onto a spoil board. If it was me, I would probably go to 12mm ply for speed. Just screw the thin gauge sheet onto that 12mm ply, just 12mm, so it can absorb the thickness of say a 10mm 8mm screw kind of thing. So I've split the beam. And you can see underneath the beam, there's now a gap. And this gap can be up to 150 millimeters. So if you, that means you can cut anything up to 150 millimeters thick in stock. And over here in the carriage, of course, we've got the Z axis, which can move the spindle down 150 millimeters as well. So it can cut your 150 millimeter stock. Next. So we get this a lot. Our motor drives are able to move at 10 meters a minute. Of course, that's way too fast for a lot of materials. And it all comes down to what your material is. Depends what you're cutting, right? And how thick you're cutting. So feeds and speeds, they are the eternal question of any CNC machine. We're not limited though by what its maximum speed is at all. So a question that came up was MDF and plywood. Typically, I would start at about the 2-3 meter mark per minute, and then I would just adjust from there. One of our major drivers is, of course, is this the SmartBench can cut as quickly as possible. This is a CNC machine. It's supposed to be doing the work for us. So one of the things that we're building into the console is the ability to say which material you're working on, which cutter you've got, and then it automatically helping you as to what recommendations are. So at least there's a very good starting point as to what your settings are. Next.
Nothing.
Okay, I'm so hungry. Can I go now? Serious note, guys, thanks a lot for watching this. We do know that we need to make much, much better videos on this, but we're literally in the process of moving in, as you can see, and it's the next thing that we're going to do, but I hope that this answers some of your questions that you've got, that we've seen in the comments, just for now. And we'll get to the good things soon, promise.
If you have any more questions, please feel free to put them in the comments, because we love answering them. It's easy content, so it's a win-win. Thanks. Oh, and subscribe and like. Happy days.